The criminal justice system. Sometimes you really want someone to have done something bad, even if they probably didn't. So you spend many months and millions of taxpayer dollars on an investigation, but the best you come up with is his son's penis pics.
Did it to me, and had they not done it to me, I think, and nobody officially said this, but I think had they not done it to me, and I'm very popular in the region, you know, they like me and I like them, the Republican Party, perhaps you wouldn't have it being done to them.
Please excuse my language, this is a direct quote, but Chrissy Teigen referred to Donald Trump as a pussy ass bitch.
Okay, free speech. And what happened after Ms. Teigen posted her tweet? What did the White House do? What did the Trump White House do?
From my understanding, the White House reached out to ask that this tweet be removed.
For 6 years, I have been the target of the unrelenting Trump attack machine shouting, "Where's Hunter?" Well, here's my answer. I am here. Here I am, Mr. Chairman, taking up your offer. When you said we can bring these people in for depositions or committee hearings, whichever they choose. Well, I've chosen. I am here to testify at a public hearing today to answer any of the committee's legitimate questions.
Here is their chance to ask Hunter questions in front of America, and they know it'll backfire, so they insist on doing it behind closed doors. And how dare you rob us of a public hearing with Hunter Biden? We all know you can't connect him to his father, but that dude's got stories to tell. Spent $683,000 on various women and took out over $1.6 million from ATMs. ATMs, $1.6 million.
I want to talk about weirdness.
One noticed it.
The only thing that I would have done differently is flung it in the direction of one person.
I want to talk about who's the weirdest. Because these people are off the chain.
Clerk, I'm proud to nominate Kevin McCarthy
to serve as Speaker of this House.
A speaker has not been elected.
It was a clean shot to kidneys, and I turned back, and there was Kevin.
The feud was between Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene and Lauren Boebert. There was reporting that the word, and pardon my language here, little bitch, was thrown around.
The House of Representatives voted today to elect Louisiana Congressman Mike Johnson, Speaker of the House. Apparently, this election result, he will accept.
You guys gotta get out of my way.
Do you have anything to say to your constituents?
Do not be fearful. If you believe your philosophy brings people more freedom, do not be fearful that you could lose your job over it. Do it anyways. I would do it all again.
But no one will let me.
He's already dead.
House Republicans did approve a Biden impeachment inquiry despite no evidence of high crimes or misdemeanors. That's not generally how the law works. License and registration, please. Sir, do you know why I pulled you over? Yeah, me neither.
But I think that this is just the tip of the iceberg. We think there are many more crimes. And my concern is that Weiss may have indicted Hunter Biden to protect him from having to be deposed.
Yes.
In the House Oversight Committee on Wednesday.
He indicted him to protect him. Yes. The classic rubric. He indicted him to protect him. I got it.
Said it before and we'll say it again. You just got tapped.
The evidence, I think, as things come out, will finally show what the trail is.
Once we show what the trail is, it'll lead us to a series of breadcrumbs
inside a conundrum and smothered in an enigma sauce. The point is, I'm hungry. Who wants lunch?
You cannot just not say you're innocent and not have to prove it.
Yes! Yes, you literally can. That's important. It's called innocent until proven guilty. This guy doesn't understand the law at all. Miranda rights. No way, I'm more of a Samantha.
I'm gonna try this. Let's see if I can put up a poll. I wanna find out from you. Who's the weirdest person in Congress? It's not limited, necessarily, to Republicans, because I'm sure there's a bizarre Democrat or two out there. My God, we're Democrats. Like Will Rogers said, I would never belong to an organized political party. That's why I'm a Democrat.
The United States Congress continues to be a brimming bucket of garbage. Carolina representative and dog who just heard the word walk, Virginia Fox.
I'd just like to tell my colleague something that I think will be easy to remember about why we're doing this. Scientist experts built the Titanic, and amateurs built the Ark.
Mr. McGovern, let me ask you a question.
I'm a very strong pro-life person. Yeah. I believe in treating people with dignity from birth to natural death.
You see what happened there? He's making your investigation sound like a joke, and he's trying to make you look like a joke. And then half of America sees that, and they think your investigation is a joke. How do you work around that? How do you work through that?
Well, that's the first time I went on CNN in 3 months. We thought we would give it a try. You know, Jake Tapper is an intelligent guy, but he's playing to a low IQ audience.
Newsmax viewers are a bunch of geniuses just because they were smart enough to find Newsmax on their cable guide. Honey, I found it up here between Telemundo After Dark and ESPN 5.5. Honey? Honey? Oh, that's right. I forgot. You left me. Anyway.
But who is the weirdest?
If find enough evidence, don't you think the voters are smart enough in those districts to say, you know what, we did vote for Biden, but this looks really bad?
And absolutely, if they have the stuff.
If they have the stuff,
Republicans
right.
at this point don't have, they've got a lot of ledgers and spreadsheets, but they have not connected the dots. They've connected the dots, the Department of Justice did, on Hunter, but they have not shown where Joe Biden, did anything illegally.
Why would Ducey say, if all the work you've done, that you have nothing? Why do you think that is?
Well, he's had that position from the very beginning. I've quit going on Fox and Friends because of Ducey.
How did Joe Biden get paid? That is the number one question, because you cannot say Hunter without saying Biden.
Yeah, that's how last names work. You also can't say Homer without saying Simpson, but that doesn't mean he was in the Bronco with OJ. It's truly tragic to watch Congress waste precious time with a sham impeachment that it could be spending on real issues that affect real people.
Now, this first one's just going to have to be my nominees. Put in the comments who you think your nominees should be. And be sure to tell me why.
They've openly admitted over and over that this whole thing is just political payback for the impeachment of Donald Trump. They're hoping their base won't notice what they're doing, and that's because they see their voters as
a low IQ audience.
But for the top five, I've gone with an obvious list. They're not in any particular order, because I wouldn't want to influence the poll. I almost don't have an opinion on this. Because these people are weird.
Well, you know, many Americans that I talk to every single day, Don, and I'm sure it's the same for you, people are hopeless, people are angry, people are disgusted with Republicans, especially in Congress, because no one is doing anything to stop the Biden regime. No one is holding anyone accountable. And I very much feel exactly the same way. As a matter of fact, I feel like I did back when I decided to run for Congress. And I ran for Congress because I was fed up with Republicans. And that's the situation we're in. The Biden administration is a communist regime. And I can't say that loud enough. And we have communists embedded in our federal agencies and departments. And that started under the Obama administration when Joe Biden was vice president.
Coming in at once again in no particular order. Coming in at number one, it's Marjorie Taylor Greene.
They're investigating our staff, looking at their social media. Everything is completely out of control. Not only do we have the D.C. jail, which is the D.C. gulag, but now we have Nancy Pelosi's gazpacho police spying on members of Congress.
The gazpacho police. Cup of Goebbels soup. Top Rommel, Lenny Biefenstock. All portrayed in the classic movie, Schindler's Bisque.
Censuring Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene. Whereas Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene has repeatedly fanned the flames of racism, anti-Semitism, hate speech against the LGBTQ community, Islamophobia, Asian hate, xenophobia, and other forms of hatred, Whereas Marjorie Taylor Greene has repeatedly debased the memories of thousands of victims of the terrorist attacks on September 11, 2001, by perpetuating conspiracy theories to shift blame and responsibility for mass murder.
No matter how much we know, so few people, even on our side, have really been able to talk about the firsthand experience, what it was like being in that building that day.
Well, that chapter is such a good chapter. That was my third day on the job as a member of Congress. I couldn't even find my way from the House chamber back to my office. I couldn't even find my way to a bathroom, let alone be able to give anyone a tour. And I was accused of giving insurrection tours in the Capitol, which is so ridiculous. But and we were in the House chamber, and we had worked diligently for weeks and weeks getting ready to object to the Joe Biden's Electoral College votes. And I took it very seriously because it was a constitutional right and duty I had as a member of Congress. I was shocked, and I was also scared because no one could tell me that those were Trump supporters. I fully believe that they were Antifa BLM rioters.
Is that a space laser in your pocket? Or are you Jewish?
Americans are tired of being. We're tired of being played for suckers.
Perhaps it's both.
You can consider your speech canceled during my time because you canceled mine. You see, you permanently banned my personal Twitter account, and it was my campaign account also. January 2nd, 2002, you permanently banned my Twitter account. This was the account that I would put my campaign ads on, raise money on, fight back when attacked with lies. So while you coordinated with DHS, the FBI, the CIA, our government, and outside groups to permanently ban, shadow ban conservative Americans and candidates like me and the former president of the United States, President Donald J. Trump, you were censoring and wrongfully violating our First Amendment free speech rights. And you want to know something? Guess what? I'm so glad that you're censored down. I'm so glad you've lost your jobs. Thank God Elon Musk bought Twitter.
About a Republican-led congressional hearing is it answers the question, what would Twitter look like if it was a physical room? Also, nothing says I'm a champion of the working class like, I'm glad you lost your jobs when the richest man in the world bought the company you worked for.
Instead of making the wealthy pay their fair share, some Republicans want Medicare and Social Security to sunset. I'm not saying it's a majority. Let me give you, anybody who doubts it, contact my office. I'll give you a copy of the proposal. That means Congress doesn't vote. I'm not saying it's a majority of you. I don't even think it's even a significant, but it's being proposed by individuals. I'm not politely not naming them, but it's being proposed by some of you. We capped the cost of insulin at $35 a month for seniors on Medicare. Let's cap the cost of insulin for everybody at $35. My administration is also taking on junk fees. We're making airlines show you the full ticket price up front and make companies disclose all the fees up front. And we'll prohibit airlines from charging $50 round trip for family just to be able to sit together. Baggage fees are bad enough. Airlines can't treat your child like a piece of baggage.
Green might actually benefit from Biden's new policies on airline fees because she's clearly carrying a lot of
baggage.
Whereas on May 20th, 2021, Marjorie Taylor Greene said that the mask mandate in the House of Representatives was akin to Jews being put in trains and taken to gas chambers in Nazi Germany.
Were you aware of this?
Congresswoman, as I said, I haven't seen the photos that you're holding up before.
Maybe, well, I posted them on my Twitter account. It's public. You know, maybe
I don't
you guys
spend a lot of time on Twitter.
Well, you know, I'm sure you do, because the Department of Homeland Security, organized with other offices, has censored many Americans, including myself.
I'm not part of the Department of Homeland Security.
Right, Mr. Ray, you should be interested in investigating terrorism.
The party of nationalism, and I'm a Christian, and I say it proudly, we should be Christian nationalists.
Whereas on November 10th, 2021, Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene referred to those who participated in the January 6th attack on the Capitol as, quote, political prisoners of war. Whereas on December 10th, 2021, Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene said that if she had organized the January 6th attack on the Capitol, quote, we would have won, not to mention we would have been armed.
I'll be really candid. I think if we had stayed together in the meeting last night, I think that you would have seen fists thrown.
If the fists did start flying, my money's on Lauren Boebert, because I've seen how fast those hands move, especially below the belt.
Coming in at number two, it's Lauren Boebert. Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice.
The church is supposed to direct the government. The government is not supposed to direct the church. That is not how our founding fathers intended it. And I'm tired of this separation of church and state junk. Did either of you approve the shadow banning of my account at Lauren Boebert? Yes or no?
No, I did not.
Not to the best of my recollection.
I'll ask again. Did you shadow ban my account? Yes or no?
Again, not to the best of my recollection.
So the answer is, Mr. Roth, yes, you did. I found out last night from Twitter staff that you suppressed my account for this tweet. It's a freaking joke about Hillary Clinton being angry that she couldn't rig her election. It's a joke. But in response, being the sinister overlords that you all are, you placed a 90-day account filter so I could not be found. You silenced me from communicating with the American people over a freaking joke. Now, who the hell do you think that you are?
It was a freaking joke, Kaylee, okay? I said it's cool you won prom queen, even though you're already the queen of bitches, Dan. It's a freaking joke.
Senators, what are you hoping to gain from an impeachment inquiry?
All I can say is Donald J. Trump 2024, baby.
Founders of this country warned against single-party impeachments, and they had a very specific reason for warning us against that. They said that it would be bitterly divisive, perhaps irreparably divisive for the country, and that's what's happened now. This is the first time in the history of this nation in 243 years that a president has been treated in this manner, when one party has followed and pursued a predetermined political outcome to get to that end.
The impeachment inquiry is necessary now, as Whip Emmer just explained, because we've come to this impasse where following the facts where they lead is hitting a stone wall, because the White House is impeding that investigation now. They're not allowing witnesses to come forward and thousands of pages of documents. So we have no choice. To fulfill our constitutional responsibility, we have to take the next step. We're not making a political decision. It's not. It's a legal decision.
Coming in at number three, it's MAGA Mike Johnson. Oh, what a tiny, tiny Johnson he must have. But let's be realistic. The man's obviously queer. I mean, come on.
Have you ever seen a Ryan Murphy TV show and thought that the homophobic characters were much too restrained and nuanced? Then you'll love Mike Johnson. If there was a bigotry hall of fame, Johnson would be well on his way to being voted in on the first ballot. He spent decades working for the ADF, or Alliance Defending Freedom, which is a very ironic name, because it's a fringe but well-moneyed far-right organization that defends so-called conservative court cases. Think evil ACLU. The ADF was behind getting Roe v. Wade overturned, several court cases defending the right of businesses to refuse service to gay people, and has fought to uphold anti-sodomy laws, which would criminalize same-sex relationships. I just want to point out here that people need to understand that sodomy means any sexual encounter that is not P&V, which means anti-sodomy laws would outlaw blowjobs. Every frat boy in America should be up in arms about this.
Kevin Spacey's character in American Beauty levels of obsessed.
I think we can all agree that Mike Johnson would be played by Kevin Spacey in a movie. That creepy hint of a smile, the dead eyes, the quiet rage that radiates from him. Perfect casting. Back in the mid-aughts when Johnson was a lawyer with ADF, he wrote multiple local newspaper editorials espousing outlandishly homophobic beliefs. Your race, creed, and sex are what you are, while homosexuality and cross-dressing are things you do. This is a free country, but we don't give special protections for every person's bizarre choices. In another op-ed, Johnson wrote, quote, homosexual relationships are inherently unnatural, and the studies clearly show are ultimately harmful and costly for everyone. Society cannot give its stamp of approval to such a dangerous lifestyle. If we change marriage for this tiny modern minority, we will have to do it for every deviant group. Polygamists, polyamorous, pedophiles, and others will be next in line to claim equal protection. They already are. There will be no legal basis to deny a bisexual the right to marry a partner of each sex or a person to marry his pet.
These gays, they're trying to murder me.
His wife was a teacher, but she has since quit her teaching career and has become a pray away the gay counselor. And about the same time she did that, actually, right before she did that, she went into a so-called covenant marriage with MAGA Mike Johnson, seen here with one of his boy toys.
Bible teaches that man has an inherently sinful nature capable of all kinds of evil. What we are seeing is the natural byproduct of a culture that increasingly denies God's existence, makes excuses for immorality, and fosters a sense of entitlement and victim mentality amongst the poor.
Roe v. Wade gave constitutional cover to the elective killing of unborn children in America, period. You think about the implications of that on the economy. We're all struggling here to cover the bases of Social Security and Medicare and Medicaid and all the rest. If we had all those able-bodied workers in the economy, we wouldn't be going upside down and toppling over like this. Listen,
the gentleman,
I will not yield. I will not.
Birth control is on the chopping block. IUDs are on the chopping block. Plan B is on the chopping block. IVF is on the chopping block.
Did you enjoy the Capitol Hill sex tape? Looking for even more hot congressional action? Then log on to Hill Hub, the nation's premier site for sex on Capitol Hill. We have all your favorite titles, like Spanker of the House.
How can a young person go into their schoolhouse and open fire on their classmates? Because we've taught a whole generation, a couple of generations now of Americans, that there is no right and wrong, that it's about survival of the fittest, and you evolve from the primordial slime. Why is that life of any sacred value? Because there's nobody sacred to whom it's owed.
Tried to will the fantasy that Biden's win was fraudulent into reality, using only the power of MAGA delusion. Remember the Texas versus Pennsylvania amicus brief that Kevin McCarthy and 125 other Republicans signed on to try to overturn the...
Johnson, you helped lead the efforts to overturn the 2020 election results. Will you...
Next question.
Coming in at number four, it's...
Few U.S. adults will be satisfied with...
Matt Gaetz will Venmo you for school after you fuck him and his friend and he gets to watch, and then they can do a train on you. Does that cost extra? Well, asking for a friend.
They also did it to fundraise. This is Florida congressman and man who spotted you from across the Build-A-Bear workshop. Matt Gaetz.
Poll watcher, filibuster nut, minority butt whip, House Subcommittee on Erection Tampering, 10-inch Legislative Branch, Department of Finance, Sperm Limits, and House Lays and Peens Committee.
At the time, he was a member-elect, so we was going through conference and orientation, and he walked up to me as Chris Yunome, now Governor Chris Yunome, and he said, man, she's a fine, and you can put the B word in place there.
The thing about this guy, this is a guy that didn't have, that the media didn't give a time of day to after he was accused of sleeping with an underage girl. And there's a reason why no one in the conference came and defended him, because we had all seen the videos he was showing on the House floor that all of us had walked away of the girls that he had slept with. He'd brag about how he would crush ED medicine and chase it with an energy drink so he could go all night. This is obviously before you got married.
Will you be satisfied? Just ask Congressman Matt Gaetz.
I rise today.
I bet you do. So log on to Hill Hub and reach around across the aisle.
Now, I don't know if it's like, you know, stupidity or straight up kink. Matt Gaetz actually had his Venmo file public. Check it out. Dude, come on, man.
Instead, Gaetz claims he and his family are the victim, the target of an extortion attempt.
On March 16th, my father got a text message demanding a meeting wherein a person
demanded $25 million in exchange for making horrible sex trafficking allegations against me go away.
I really tell he's speaking from the heart and not from a statement his lawyer wrote on the screen.
It's suggesting that the talk show host had dinner with Gates and a woman who could be at the center of the investigation by the FBI into Gates' conduct. Carlson said he did not remember the woman or the dinner.
I don't remember the woman you're speaking of or the context at all, honestly. But I would like to know who. So they're saying there is a 17-year-old girl who you had a relationship with. Is that true? And who are they? Who is this girl? What are they talking about in the New York Times?
The person doesn't exist. I have not had a relationship with a 17-year-old. That is totally false. I'm not the only person on screen right now who's been falsely accused of a terrible sex act. You were accused of something that you did not do, and so you know what this feels like.
It's like, how the hell did I get roped into this?
Even Carlson left the interview sounding confused.
If you just saw our Matt Gaetz interview, that was one of the weirdest interviews I've ever conducted.
In light of what this president has been able to do leading our country, in light of the economic growth, what he's done with our Supreme Court justice, what he's done with the embassy in Jerusalem, a host of things, you really think the American people are like, wait a minute, so Rudy Giuliani, the president's private lawyer, had a conversation with
I think that you came here and leveled a bunch of accusations and allegations about Hunter Biden.
I didn't level, I just said the facts. Didn't he get paid $50,000 a month?
He was paid by a foreign company, yeah. He was paid by Burisma. But Joe Biden was trying to get a prosecutor who was not pursuing corruption fired, and it was supported.
It's amazing the gymnastics you guys will go through to defend what you really
sir,
think
it's
the,
not
vice
gymnastics,
the vice
it's
president,
facts.
The vice president,
and I would
of the
think
United
somebody
States.
Who's been accused of things in the last year or two would be more sensitive about throwing out wild allegations.
I'm not
against
throwing
people.
Out wild. I'm throwing out the facts.
The Ohio Attorney General Dave Yost, who claimed that story, claimed that he found no evidence to support this allegation that this 10-year-old girl from Ohio had to travel to Indiana to have this abortion. Jordan tweeted, another lie, anyone surprised? Then he deleted that tweet. So I asked him about that and whether he would apologize to the family. Why'd you delete the tweet?
Well, because we learned that this illegal alien did this heinous crime. So we deleted the tweet.
And number five, and once again, this is in no particular order because this bad boy could be shooting up to number one anytime, like a bullet. It's Jim. I want to touch you down there, Jordan.
Just what Americans need is more imagination from Democrats.
The Democrats.
Democrats. It's been the Democrats.
The Democrats are.
Democrats don't want to address the underlying problems. When you pay people not to work, you shouldn't be surprised when you can't find workers. When you defund the police, you shouldn't be surprised when you get more crime.
That drives me crazy.
So Joe Biden won fair and square.
He won the election because the way the process works is the last chance to object is January 6th.
Never said it was stolen, Mr. Chairman. I'll give you the same answer. Never said it was. I said we should investigate it.
Something wasn't right with this election. Five key states that were critical in this election changed their election law.
This is just another attempt to go after President Trump.
You can try to put a ribbon on a sham process, but that doesn't make it any less of a sham.
And let's be clear. You don't need a full vote of the House to proceed in an impeachment inquiry phase of our constitutional duty to do oversight. In fact, the Democrats did it.
And now an indictment of a former president, the guy who happens to be leading in every single poll. I mean, I've seen church prayer chains that are easier to understand than this.
You don't know who was in the meeting?
Which meeting are you referring to?
The meeting that never happened. Who was in it? Mr. Chairman, I don't want you to answer my question. The American people want Dr. Fauci to answer the question. What does it have to be?
Expire, sir.
You need to respect the chair and shut your mouth.
Prosecutor was not pursuing corruption. That's why the entire West wanted him fired, including anti-corruption activists in Ukraine. I don't understand what you don't get about that.
I get that. I'm just talking about this specific case that there's been reporting on, and the facts of that specific case are what he was paid per month, $50,000. Like I said, that's more than some of the folks I get the privilege of representing in the 4th District of Ohio get paid in a year. He's getting that $50,000 a month. The vice president's son, he got hired for what?
The president's daughter right now is having all sorts of copyrights granted in foreign countries. That doesn't alarm you. The president's sons are doing all sorts of business all over the world. That doesn't alarm you.
Come on.
Dennis Hastert was an admitted pedophile.
used multiple young boys and tried to hide his horrific actions with payoffs.
I think that should be the new Hastert rule, okay? Anybody in the house who was involved in any way or helped cover up wrestling coaches touching their wrestling boys and or their doctors, that should be the Hastert rule. Jim Jordan is currently in violation of the Hastert rule. The other Hastert rule will never apply to him. The one that they still call the Hastert rule for some reason, I can't believe they don't rename it. It's the one where you won't bring a thing to the floor unless you have enough votes. Jim Jordan's never actually introduced a bill. Not one time. So, of course, the Hastert rule wouldn't apply. But the new Hastert rule damn sure does.
But the American people are demanding to see Hunter Biden's nudes. And you better not make them pay to see it. There's nothing worse than expecting a free peek at male genitals only to find out there are hidden...
Junk fees.
Come on. Either there's a principle that people should not benefit from their connections, or there isn't.
The previous administration's FBI went after this president on July 31st.
They did a crappy job then because they didn't even acknowledge there was an investigation until after the election.
They spied on two Americans associated with President Trump's campaign. They put Peter Strzok in charge of that campaign. The guy who said Trump should lose $100 million. They allowed Jim Comey leaked documents to get a special counsel. They used a dossier to go get a warrant.
Now we're back to the dossier.
I'm just saying that's what happened to President Trump. And now that none of that worked. I understand you want to change the subject,
but the president was pushing the president of Ukraine to investigate a political rival. I cannot believe that that is okay with you. I can't believe it's okay with you.
Jim Jordan is not out of the mix. I've talked to a lot of people who still support him. I've actually talked to Democrats who trust him at his word. I don't think that's out of the realm of possibility.
Jim Jordan?
Yes, I've talked to Democrats over the last week on who do they trust, even though they wouldn't agree with him on many issues. He is someone.
The Jim Jordan from Ohio?
I think it's because he likes skin tights. But that's just a rumor.
Jim Jordan is only accused of enabling sexual abuse, and the victims weren't children. He is the progress we need. Jim Jordan, not as bad as a pedophile.
Whereas on May 25th, 2021, Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene tweeted, quote, vaccinated employees get a vaccination logo just like the Nazis forced Jewish people to wear a gold star.
Marjorie Taylor Greene wants to be in leadership. Bobart wants to be in your pants. And she's willing to, you know, take money for that, too. Just ask Ted Cruz. MAGA Mike Johnson also wants to get in your pants. Just ask Ted Cruz. Matt Gaetz does not want to get in your pants because you're over 17. Jim Jordan wants to watch some guy get in somebody else's pants. Specifically, a wrestler's pants.
Three guys who are also known by their nicknames.
Pussy ass bitch.
So, if I can figure out how to do it, there's going to be a poll coming up right here with this video. Let me know who's the craziest, who's the nuttiest, who's the weirdest person in Congress. Weirdness is the actual question. But obviously, multiple words can apply.
No, Latina, several children stacked on top of each other, an old woman from the future.
Colleagues who are more worried about getting drunk every night with the next lobbyist that they're going to screw and pretend like none of us know what's going on. This happens every single week. Where are the ethics investigations and that?
I may or may not have a write-in space. I don't know if I will or not. I haven't decided.
The United States Congress, there's felons galore. There's people with all sorts of shiesty backgrounds. And all of a sudden, George Santos is the Mary Magdalene of United States Congress.
Let's make one thing very clear. If any Republican is Mary Magdalene, it's Ron DeSantis. I mean, with those hooker boots, come on. He's clearly working the streets at night. He's like, I'll suck your dick if you teach me how to smile normal.
All these fuckers are about to take a dive.
sleeping with lobbyists, and profiting as much as possible at the expense of the people. We all know that already. What we don't know are the specifics. Tell us who, what, where, which orifice.
Now, of course, Marjorie Taylor Greene obviously did porn. Check out my video on that, y'all. It's her.
Whereas on December 19th, 2021, while at a Turning Point USA conference, Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene referred to Asian Americans as, quote, yellow people, a slur that has been historically used to malign the Asian American community in the United States. Whereas,
we, the church, are God's governing body on the earth. Whereas we have been given legal power from heaven and now exercise our authority. Whereas we are God's ambassadors and spokespeople over the earth, whereas through the power of God, we are the world influencers, whereas because of our covenant with God, we are equipped and delegated by Him to destroy every attempted advance of the enemy.
Whereas on June 17th, 2020, Politico reported that Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene referred to black Americans as, quote, slaves to the Democratic Party and said that they should be proud to see Confederate monuments.
But, you know, a lot of people have done porn. At this point, I bet you the numbers are comparable to the prostitutes.
Whereas on June 17th, 2020, Politico further reported that Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene stated in a video, quote, I know a ton of white people that are as lazy and sorry and probably worse than black people.
And I don't. You look down on somebody for being a prostitute? Hell, for many, many centuries, they were the only people in society that were honest. Tell you what, man. Nobody puts in a hard day work like she does. Those girls earn their money. Just ask Ted Cruz.
Whereas on May 18th, 2023, Marjorie Taylor Greene compared being called a white supremacist to a person of color being called the N-word, a vile racial slur.
Funneled $175,000 into her nothing campaign. Never met her. Didn't know who she was. She had no shot. Right after a Colorado trip where they never met. Could you imagine what it takes to do Ted Cruz? You better give me a damn congressional seat. I'm Zachariah Lone Star Liberal. Y'all take it easy.
Whereas on July 19th, 2023, Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene displayed graphic pornographic images during an official committee hearing that she claimed depicted a member of President Biden's family.
I'm just a bill. Yes, I'm only a bill. And I just got railed on Capitol Hill.